might worry my friends and family is what's going to happen when the wide audience sees it.
Pleasure, the movie, is about a young Swedish woman who goes to LA with the ambition of becoming the next big porn star. And it's a look on this very male-dominated world from a female perspective.
Bella, which is the main character, she's a very powerful and brave woman. She takes the power away from men by sexualizing herself or objectifying herself. But she also is quite naive and doesn't really know what she's getting herself into. The movie is not only about porn. It's a reflection of our society in general. I don't think it has to do necessarily with celebrities and becoming famous. I think it goes for any job, any career. And I think it goes for all women when I say that no matter what you do, you're always going to need to use different types of strategies to survive a patriarchic society. It doesn't matter if you work at a supermarket or if you're a porn star, because you're going to have to adapt.
Many women can relate to what Bella is going through, even though they've never done porn themselves. It's mirroring our society, or like structures that are patriarchal structures, but also like capitalism in a way, like when profit rules over like solidarity or camaraderie or humanity, these things is gonna happen. The whole idea of the American dream, that like if you work hard enough, then you might be the one who's actually against all odds gonna make it all the way. But what about the rest? What about your friends? What about all the other people? So aren't we gonna, like, isn't it better to try to get the working conditions or whatever it is better for everyone? Instead of like doing your own, like trying yourself just to reach the top.
Who's the girl? That's the new Spiegler girl.
What's the Spiegler girl?
They're like the A-listers of porn. Hey, pick up the phone, who's
bold enough to try and call my bluff? It was through a friend that me and Ninja have in common. He told me that he thought that I had what she was looking for. So he asked if I wanted to go to an audition. And my initial thought was absolutely not, because I had never done anything with theater or acting at all. But at that time I was in therapy, so I had an assignment to do anything that scared me, so therefore I did it. But I didn't think I would get the part. But during my audition, I had like an outer bodily experience where I really felt like I was Bella, and that I wasn't me. And I really, really enjoyed it. And then Ninja quite quickly made her decision. My mom, she was a bit worried in the beginning, but then I told her, like, Google Ninja, and then you call me back. And that made her worry less. Everyone's super, super proud of me. My mom watched the movie with all my aunts, and they were all very proud of me. I brought my brother for the Sundance screening. Everyone's really, really proud of me. They understand why I wanted to make this movie, and they understand the importance of it. I didn't make a movie just to exploit myself, and the movie isn't exploiting me at all. And I think that is very good for my family to know, like, as they've seen it, that it wasn't what they might have imagined it to be.
I want to be a Spiegler girl.
Your social media is pretty small. You have no fan base yet.
Can't speak? Just give me a little tap, and that means, like, chill out.
Yeah. She definitely can't tap you.
I had a lot of prejudice before going to Los Angeles, but the movie and the pre-production and the research really changed my view quite a lot. It made it really hard for me to only see the differences, because there are too many similarities. They're just normal people, and I thought otherwise. Definitely change how I view the industry and how I view sex workers in general, because I'm kind of ashamed that I had the prejudice that I had.
Most porn sets that that I've visited, people are friendly and nice. No one's like trying to force anyone to do anything or convince someone to do something that they're not comfortable with. So, but there are also those porn sets where it's abusive, and that happens as well. Watching a horror movie, there's something that is very scary or could be violent, and it doesn't have to be, no one has to be hurt for real. Like, you can do that in a way where the people who does it enjoys it, but it's just very important to be very careful and do it the right way. And it's important to notice the difference and be aware of that there are both of these things are happening, because there's a lot of really great porn sets, and there's also some really bad ones.
Why aren't you like doing something better with your life and trying to be a singer?
I just love cock. It's a subject that is very taboo. We have sexual education in Sweden, but we don't talk about porn. And it's always been one of those things that, like, you know that everyone is watching it, but no one says they do. So it really fascinated me.
I hope that the film is going to help for people to be more open towards sex workers and be more respectful to sex workers when talking about it, and because the stigma towards sex workers is really like a huge problem. Like, the people consume their work but then judge them and don't want to admit that they are actually the ones who it's like, because what they are doing is based out of like the consumer's fantasies, what they want. But also hopefully it's gonna have an impact in some ways on the industry of like showing like how important it is to really be more aware of the female perspective, because it's so still very, very male dominated. Most directors are men, most companies are owned by men, most agents are men, so it's in a way like the men is owning the industry, and then the women are doing the work with their bodies. But I think it's about to change, since like with social media and OnlyFans, that the women are getting more and more, and the male performers as well, are getting more and more like control over the content and the work, and they can decide on their working conditions. So that's a positive development.